Welcome to the day four of our class, okay? I gave you assignment last time. Were you able to go through the assignment? I told you to list the generation of computers and just explain them based on its technology, give an example of each, the characteristics, and the uses. And we also told you that we also need to write something about the speed of computer. What do you know about computer, what computer is used of? So, how many of us are able to go through that assignment and many of us are able to submit it in the submission group? Please note one thing. When you do assignment, when you practically get yourself involved, mentally get yourself involved, you learn better. If I'm just waiting for me to just teach like this, just passing in, you think you are grabbing it, well, you might be grabbing it, but you must still lose a lot. So it's better to get yourself involved. And that's the essence of assignment. Assignment makes you to know where you understand, where you need to work on, and stuff like that. So please, don't joke with assignment. Write it and the assignment. Do it practically and submit it. Okay? Submit it. It pays you to submit your assignment. Because that is the only way you can grow further. So for those of you who are able to attend the assignment, I will say, thank you so much. For those not able to attend it for now, I also thank you and implore you to do that next time. Don't forget, subscribe to this channel. Let friends know about it. Bring people who want to learn these things and you too learn from it. Like I said, we are on a journey. And the journey is a long journey. By the end of the journey, you're going to become a professional, a computer guru, and use it to make money. Okay? So, let me now solve the assignment on the generation of computer we stopped last time. I just give you a preamble about computer generation, how computer evolved. But today, I want to now tell you the evolution of computer that is divided into five generations, as I told you earlier on. I will now differentiate them based on technology, examples, and characteristics in their uses. Okay? So, let's get started with the first generation. And that happened in 1940s to 1950s. Okay, time of our parents, right? Or maybe our great grandparents, because some of us were very kids. Okay, so at that time, the generation of computer has the following distinct feature. This feature means characteristics. Okay, you can know them by this character. One, the technology area they used then was vacuum tubes. Okay, vacuum tubes, and as a good example, one of them is ENIAC. Electronic Numeric Integrators Computer. Electronic Numeric Integrators Computer. Okay? ENIAC. So, and what are these characteristics again? It's very large. It's power hungry. You need to power him. And you generate a lot of heat. If you are there, you know. And those days, there's nothing like AC. So, what do they use it for? Can you imagine? It's used for basic calculations and data processing. So, imagine that period of time. People who lack vision, who does not believe in what computer will be, we think that, what are we just wasting our time? So we are suffering the top of this thing called technology or machine. But look at computer today. Because for our parents then have a vision, they continue suffering and using that way till we get to this future generation. So now let's move to the second generation of computer. This happened within 1950s to 1960s. And also have some distinct features, okay? They are more than characteristics, okay? Because characteristics are under features as well. So they are more than characteristics. So what are these features? What do they know for? What are they noted for? In terms of technology, they make use of transistors. And a good example is IBM 1401. You can browse this into on Google. You know, most of them are training, I've trained you in Google. So there, why do I use training on Google? So I can go to Google, type it and see it. You click on image, you see the image. So okay, this is IBM 1401. Okay, so you can browse these things and also learn more from there. Then what are its characteristics? What are its character? It's only smaller compared to the first one. It's more reliable. It's more energy efficient. It doesn't consume a lot of power than the first generation of computers. And this one is used for best application like payroll, inventory management, and the rest of them. So you find out that there is a little bit improvement. Great improvement, you know, but less a little bit compared to what's in the problem we have now. But then, it was a very great improvement. Because now, not just simple calculation, but now you can now do business application, like your payroll, your inventory management, you can now use them there. So business aspect now starts coming into play. And there comes the third generation. This will happen in 1960s to 1970s. And this generation to also have some distinct feature that actually characterizes it from every other generation. In terms of technology, using integrated circuits, ICs. And that was why IC starts coming. I'm not showing IC when I show you the motherboard. But you can type, you see ICs on the motherboard, the ICs on the motherboard. Example of that one is I'll talk about IBM System 360. You can also Google that. Just Google it, okay? And what is character? It becomes more smaller than the second generation and become more powerful. The other one is powerful in energy consumption. But this one is powerful in work, okay? And it allows for development of more sophisticated softwares and operating system. It now make room for programmers, software engineers to come in and then start their work. It's fine that the third generation of computer actually is a way forward. It's like a milestone. You know, they now start seeing the future, the vision, they're taking shapes. Okay? And there comes the fourth generation. And that happened in the 1970s to the present. Yeah, we are still using the fourth generation. Why the fifth generation is elapsing between the two, but I won't get that, we'll explain that. So, the fourth generation, what are its distinct future? In terms of technology, they now start using microprocessors. Central processing unit, microprocessors. Processors that are micro, not small processors. Example, you have your personal computers, like the Apple II, the IBM PC, and stuff like that. Now, what is character? There is dramatic increase in power reduction and reduction in size. The size reduced drastically. The power reduction reduced drastically. You can now make use of your battery, little things to charge it. You know? Isn't that great? Technology is moving. The world is going technologically. That's why advancement technology started taking place. So personal computers become more affordable and become more widespread. And this is the development of softwares for a wide range of applications. Okay? Now have software like your OS, operating system. You have software like your Microsoft Word. You have software like maybe you can build websites. I'm just talking about things you know. Okay? This is not, there are many powerful software, but I'm talking about the ones that relate to you that you can easily understand, okay? You know that if you go to Microsoft, for instance, you want to type, you want to send a message, it's because someone programmed it like that. Yeah, and that is software, okay? So from there, we now came to first, fifth generation, and that is for present and beyond. So we are in fifth generation and also in fourth generation. The fourth generation is already giving way for the fifth generation. We are not completely giving way for the fifth generation. So that's why I say that the generation is now like an interface between the fourth and the fifth, and the future lasts beyond, okay? And then, what kind of technology do we use in the fifth generation? Then, you talk about artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence, AI, and advanced microprocessor technology. You see people, you now talk about people who write scripts, who give AI, you give instruction, AI will carry out work. AI now start coming out, talking to people. To the extent that even in Ojeziri, AI is being interviewed like human being, and they talk like human being. They have a lot of languages that they have imbued in them. If you want to know, if you want to listen to AI talks, see him physically on Ojeziri when she was interviewed, Sonia, just tell me and I'll send it to you. Just send me a message and I'll send it to you, okay? I have it on my YouTube. And you listen to what they say there, you see how intelligent artificial intelligence can be. But remember, who made it is not man. Who made man is not God. So that shows that no matter how, they are still limited. Okay? So we have examples like modern computers, your smartphone, your AI systems like IBM's Watson, you know, or ChatGPT and the rest of them. Characteristics of this one is that it's focused majorly on AI and machine learning. And these computers can now understand natural language. It can recognize patterns and make decisions. You know, things that computer can never do before now. they now become highly interconnected. Enabling advanced communication and data processing capabilities. So you find out that the future of computer is a technology. It's a, you will not talk about blockchains, talk about cryptocurrencies, you know. So things are then moving like the speed of light. That is the future generation of a computer. At your own time, go through the summary. The summary will tell you how these things evolve and a little note about them, okay? I've shown you the picture before, so I'm not going to show you the picture again. So, but right now, we're going to move to the next one. We'll talk about how computer can be classified. We're going to talk about based on type and signal that they process. But let me check out time, because I don't want us to go over time. Like I told you, this class should not exceed 10 minutes. It's already more than 10 minutes. So, see you in our next class. Okay?